Good day and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, after a long while, I'm finally finishing up this video where I'll be discussing child armatures in use for your animations in DragonBones Pro. Now, just looking at the list here, I've got quite a few visible already. So aerials, doors, engines, main, mid-exhaust, a little screw, and also these two here, trailer 1 and trailer 2. Now, please ignore trailer 1 and trailer 2. As I did use this in the test earlier for my actual animation sequence to see if I can actually simplify that trailer construction, but obviously it didn't work out as I wanted, that it was just too complex, and I replaced it with a different system itself to control the bending of those items. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete them. In any case, if you want to create a child armature, you can just select a new symbol command there, type in the name you want, and it will save towards your project folder. Nothing too fancy about it. I'm not really going to cover too much about that. What we'll be covering is just looking at a specific armature, in this case the exhaust itself. Just switching over there, and we can see that it exists with normal entities, bones, images, and as usual, your animations. So I don't really have to go into that. These are small animations, and these could be weaponry or elemental effects or whatever the case you want to be to add on top of your character animation. This will make it a lot easier to actually animate smaller components apart from, or how's that word, separate from your main entity itself. It will make things a little bit easier, that your timeline isn't too cluttered with a lot of keyframes in the timestamp. In any case, you can see I've added the bone there, and this is assigned to a specific child armature, and it does link to original bones, so you don't have to control the movements of itself either. So it keeps track with your actual physical object, like for instance a sword to a hand. So noting that it references to all of the animations on default, and it consists of two objects, the actual bone as well as the actual image items itself, which can be switched off in your main panel. Now, just looking at this, what I've got here is a default animation playing. This is on default, will be the same. Your first animation in the child armature will play, and we have to control that for a specific reason. So just looking at quickly, if I select my actual bone, you won't have any control of that, but if you select the image, you'll be able to specify, looking at your properties on the left, what child armature you want to play. In this case, I've got the front exhaust linked to that bone, and I can choose between that. This also means that you can have multiple child armatures linked to one specific bone, making the switching of weapons maybe a lot easier. Obviously, I'll leave room for your imagination to play on that. A very important thing to note is at the bottom, which is the play animation sequence, is you have to have this ticked, because if it's not ticked and you actually export your project, it will not play the animation, even though it looks like in your timeline it is playing, but it won't export with your specific project. So what we've got to do is we've got to make sure that that option is ticked and the correct animation is selected. Now I'm just going to show you that you can have multiple animations playing in one main animation sequence. Noting that, say for instance, on about 61, I'm going to apply the front exhaust idle animation, and we can see it switches from no animation to that specific animation itself. You can use it in time to drag the sequence on itself to say, okay, maybe 3 frames left or 20 frames later, but in this case I'm just going to have it from start to finish. So yeah, that's about it for child armature animations. So what we're going to look at now as well, just quickly showing you that this animation is a composite of various sub-entities like images and so forth, just as you normally would create a default armature. Okay, so moving on. Adding these child armatures is actually quite simple. You would go throughout the process of creating new bones as normally would, with the image select option off, so it doesn't actually link that bone to the background image. So just a normal procedure. And I'm just going to use the backdraft here of my completed item here just to reference the correct locations in for those aerials, which in fact I have created the animations previously, and as a matter of fact, I'm just applying it to those specific bones. Okay. Now, I'm just going to rename this to make it a bit more clearer for me for where I actually am in my project. Aerial 1 and Aerial 2. And then I'll show you guys how to add this. Now, looking at one of these bones, if I right click, you'll see you can't really specify child armature. You have the normal default options, but it says nothing about a child armature. Not in the properties, not in the main menu. It actually says it nowhere. So how does this work? Well, it's as simple as left click, drag onto the bone in the main panel to the bone you want to apply it. And there you go. Let me add aerial 1 as well to the correct bone. I'm just going to draw order as you normally would with any images and just applying to the bottom of the cab. And once we play, we can see the default animation pops through for those aerial animations. Now obviously, as I mentioned before, it's very important to actually specify what animation you are playing in that instance. Otherwise, it's not going to export with your project. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed it, please hit the like button. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe.